Joining me now is John Martinko, president of veteran-owned and run financial firm Drexel Hamilton. Happy Veterans Day, John. Before we get to the IPO market, we want to talk to you about a special initiative that you have for Veterans Day today.
Yeah, our firm's been out there in the local community all week. We've had over a dozen events. Last night, we teamed up with BurgerFi, Ticker BFI, their truck, several locations in the Camillus House, a homeless shelter in South Miami. And 20% of those residencies are military veterans. So it's really great, our employees, to get out there. And more importantly, and we were actually partnered up with a Cyril Spackishore Lionheart and their executive team to make that happen. So really great evening to get in the community and give back to military veterans this entire week.
John, absolutely. Great cause. Thank you for your service. Thank you for the service of everybody that works there at Drexel Hamilton. Let's get down to business now. We're talking about IPOs. There have been 372 IPOs this year, more than double what we saw in 2020. Why are companies looking to IPOs as a way to get into the market as opposed to direct listings or even SPACs? They have other alternatives. Why are IPOs so hot?
Yeah, Frank, I think you're going to see the optionality of all three of those that you just listed, whether it is direct listing or regular way, or let's not forget the SPAC market, extremely hot. On top of that, 379 IPOs that you just listed, 537 have priced year to date. So we're seeing a continuation of that. And also to note, our desk, our bankers, our originators are seeing an increase and uptick in filings for those type of acquisition and blank check companies. And so I expect the IPO market to remain strong into year end, the little window that we have now to Thanksgiving, finish up the year in first quarter Q1 to continue to see the spike in demand for IPO issuance.
You know, John, strong IPO market, but not all of them are successful. This year, more than 22 IPOs have doubled from their opening price. They include companies like Affirm and Doximity, even Portillo's, the Chicago hot dog restaurant. I like those hot dogs. But there are 179 IPOs trading below their price. They include very notably Robinhood, also Oatly. What does that say about the current climate of IPOs?
I know it's saturated. However, I do believe that Robinhood situation maybe is an outlier. But look at the top of the show, the Rivian, up another 20% today. So take a peek at the demand, the subscription going into the new issuance date, the night of pricing. That will help you determine the winners from the losers. However, I will tell you the market, too, what we're seeing, not just the investors are getting more sophisticated around the blank check and the SPAC companies and the regular way IPOs, but the bankers and those in the capital markets that we work alongside that we can't thank enough and who do a tremendous amount for us and our military veteran firm to give back to those local communities that we did this week and every day. Every day here, we like to say at Drexel Hamilton, is a military Veterans Day. And without them, not much of this could take place.
So, John, let me steer you back to something that you tantalizingly dropped in there, telling the difference between the IPOs that are going to succeed and stay inflated. And I don't mean inflated in price, but I mean retain rather than the ones that are going to lose helium and go back down. What do you look for so that you are one of the ones that's not like Robinhood, that's not like an IPO that loses its juice? What do you look for?
The demand, Tyler. Great question and a great series here. The demand and how the book builds. Who are those anchor tenants? It's always a tried and true reflection of just the quality of the order and the type of investors that company has behind them. That is a great indicator of how the stock will perform down the road into its quarterly earnings when they report.
Yeah, well, we will see with Rivian, certainly a wonderful debut going up again today. They've delivered, I think it's 156 automobiles and trucks so far. We'll see where it goes. John Martinko, congratulations on your initiatives today and all the good work you're doing. And thank you again for your service.